Coming up in this video, we're going to be talking about VidIQ Basic, the free browser extension to help you with the growth and management of your YouTube channel. Hi, welcome and welcome back to my channel. If you don't know me already, my name is Anton Wong and I help you understand, unlock, and unleash the power of online video with videos about video production, media marketing, and career and business development. So if you haven't already yet, subscribe. But onto the video. Now, VidIQ is not just a powerful keyword research tool, which it is, but also provides data to help users optimize their YouTube videos and their channels to help them grow. And it also contains a multitude of other features that help with channel management and channel growth. VidIQ has a free version called VidIQ Basic and also multiple paid versions called Pro and Boost. Today, we'll just be talking about the VidIQ Basic, the free version, because it's the only one that I've had experience so far. And just for your information, I am not sponsored in any way by VidIQ, but I will leave an affiliate link in the description if you guys want to sign up. I'll get more into the review and my thoughts of VidIQ later on in the video, but first let's talk about all the features that come with VidIQ. And most of these features you can customize and toggle on and off by going to your VidIQ settings. It is worth noting that I can only find this extension available on Firefox and Chrome, so if you use another browser that is not supported, I'm sorry. But let's start off with my favorite feature and tool. The YouTube search panel is my favorite tool of the free version so far. It shows up on the right-hand side of search terms whenever you search something. It shows how many people are viewing videos with this keyword prominently, as well as some other things like the average views, and also which channels are the most prominent with these keywords. Another thing is that it gives a VidIQ score, which gives an overall keyword score, which is based on how many people are searching for that keyword versus how many videos are actually surfaced. So basically, volume of searches versus the competition of videos. The higher demand and less score, the higher it will be. Generally, scores above 60 or 70 will be good keywords to be used. I sometimes like using this to just sit down at a few hours at a time and just looking up a bunch of keywords that are related to video ideas that I might have, and then writing down all the keywords that I have searched and tested to see which ones I might want to start off first. Next feature is the real-time analytics tool. It's in the top right part of the YouTube page. It just gives you a quick overview of how many views your channel is getting in the past little bit, as well as how many subscribers you get and how many watch hours you have. You can also just toggle on and off which ones you want to see. Then you also have the like and dislike ratio for videos. It shows you on each video what the ratio of likes to dislikes are. Now, lower percentages don't necessarily mean a bad video. They could just be a controversial topic, or maybe the viewers just disagree with the uploader. Also, sometimes if a video gets very few likes, like 4 likes to 1 dislike, well then that's going to be 80 and not 100. Sometimes people do actually click dislike just by accident. Anyway, onto the video info panel. When you're watching a video, on the right-hand side shows the video info panel. You get an overview of the statistics of that video. You also get to see the video's engagement rate and how people are reacting to the video here on YouTube and also on other social media platforms. You also get to see how well the video is optimized for SEO, based on keywords and titles and other factors. You can also compare this video's view trajectory with your channel average or the last video you watched, but if you want to compare it with other videos or other channel averages or anything like that, you're going to have to upgrade. The video info panel will also give you a quick look at the channel's analytics. You can also view video tags as well as channel tags that the video and channel is using, as well as where this video ranks in search for those keyword terms. Next, if you go into people's specific channels, you can see some things like their statistics. You can also view the channel's top trending videos, the ones that are having the highest views per hour. And you can add them to 3 competitor channels if you'd like. But like I said, a lot of these functions are kind of locked to the paid versions of Pro and the Boost version. Next, you have upload features. When you're uploading a video, you get a little checklist of the different things that you can do to help optimize your video for success. You also get the little VidIQ optimization score, which just also helps you do the same thing. Next, you get comment features. On your own video, you can create and save comment templates, which you can use for faster commenting. You also get to view the subscriber count of the commenters who make their subscriber count public, and you also get to filter comments by various things like subscriber count as well as amount of replies. You can also filter by questions, which is great if you want to just answer a bunch of questions from a bunch of commenters. And finally, you get channel audits and channel achievements. Channel audit basically just shows you what you're doing well, what you should maybe be doing more of, just based on what videos are performing the best, as well as maybe other things that you should do in your videos when you're uploading to optimize, whether it's longer descriptions or different titles or different tags, things like that. And channel achievements are pretty self-explanatory. If you reach 1,000 subscribers or if you reach 10,000 video views, then they'll just show you that you have reached that achievement. Now, more onto my thoughts. Like I said, I've just been using this for about a year, a little over a year, and there are some things that you don't get with the free version that I obviously do wish that you would get more things with the free version. Features like in-depth keyword research or trending video search, or even adding more competitors, stuff like that. The extension itself overall can sometimes be a little bit clunky when loading, even though I'm using a very powerful desktop PC, which is wired in directly into my internet. And for the design and usability, the design is okay, and the user experience and UI of it is okay, I guess. But like I said, this is the free version that I'm using, VidIQ Basic. And for a free extension, it offers quite a bit. I mean, it's free. It's really hard to complain with free. And like I said, my favorite feature is the search panel and search score. It's very helpful when researching keyword topics and titles so that you can know what keywords and what titles and what video topics you might want to cover for your next videos. Recently, I've just sat down and for a whole day, I would do nothing but just researching and typing in a bunch of different video keywords and video search terms and to see where they rank and then put it into a document and just file it by what their keyword search is and what the average view gets and what the competition is like. And the other thing I love is the comment filter, which allows you to filter through different things like based on which has replies or which comments don't have replies or which comments have profanity or which comments have the most likes or subscriber count. And also on my own videos, I can create and save comment templates, which makes commenting faster. And as you guys may or may not know, writing comments on other people's videos as well as replying to as many comments on your videos is a great way to build community and be a part of other people's community. And building and growing community is a great way to build and grow your YouTube channel. So final thoughts, I think that every YouTuber should get VidIQ Basic to help grow their channel and help manage their channel a little bit. And if they want to go a step further and get those extra locked features, then I think it might actually be worth it. I might go and test it myself with maybe a free trial or something. And like I said, I'll be leaving an affiliate link in the description below for you guys to try it if you would like. And if you want to get a complete refresher on how to get started making videos on YouTube, you can click or tap right here so you can watch my beginner's guide. If you happen to appreciate this video or found some value out of it, be sure to hit like. Feel free to leave any questions that you have in the comments below. And until then, I will see you guys in the next video.